It was the perfect hype fight. The young upstart with charisma, arrogance, and a heap of talent, and the wily veteran with a string of impressive title defences to his name. Thousands packed Cardiff Arms Park in Wales in the hope of seeing the flashy Prince Naseem sent packing back to England. Prince had other plans.
Robinson, the defending champion, is the natural man at this weight. As the weight begins to fall and it's getting heavier. 12 rounds for the WBO Featherweight Championship. Starts to land cleanly. And the punches bounce off Robinson, who's never been stopped. He's got a good tight defense, Robinson.
He just near diagonally, just as Robinson left the ring, saying, keep it tight, keep it tight. So they probably expected a very fast start from Hamed.
He gets through Robinson. Hamed waves him in. Style of his arms down by his hips, punches coming from crazy angles, very hard to prepare for because you never quite know what he's going to do next, and I sometimes wonder if he does. I've never seen Hamed put under pressure or in a crisis before. Can Robinson achieve that? I think maybe his backup plan here might be to try and draw Hamed's sting and then wear him down later on. That's it.
Yes, it certainly looks that way. He's keeping very, very tight. You see the guard well protecting him. You see the guard of Hamed very open.
Robinson's a little bit excited, but he might be made to look a bit silly for the first three rounds missing. But he says, I'll get the job done. Don't worry about that.
You should see the style of Hamed, very loose, pitches coming from all sorts of angles. Another cut, he brought it right from the floor, right at the middle. Good of a cut from Hamed.
Showboating already from Hamed. Trying to lure Robinson in, no doubt with the aim of counter-punching him, but Robinson's not buying that. He's fighting out of that high-held guard, and just waiting his chances.
Yes, Robinson said he wasn't going to chase him, he was going to let Hamed come to him. He knows he's the champion, Hamed has got to take the title away from him.
Nothing very much has got through from either of them in this first round. There's a lot in here in the gloves, the high held gloves, particularly of the champion, Robinson. Fascinating opening round. This is going to be cagey, nip and tuck, you feel.
Second round.
And seven of Naseem's wins have come in this round. This is a round he tends to favour after a quiet opening round. Now let's see what he can make of Robinson's strategy here.
Robinson not doing a great deal at the moment. He's just keeping very tight. He's letting Hamed lead to him. He's obviously going to look to counter.
Hamed so far is finding it difficult to find a way through. Now Robinson will look to try and cut him off on those ropes and get through with the right hand. One of the problems Robinson might have here is getting closer now with this slippery, quicksilver, elusive young man from Sheffield. To wear him down, he's got to be landing punches. So he's hitting the gloves with those jabs at the time because they're only about 5 or 6 feet away from him.
Yes, he's just flicking the gloves. What he's trying to do is get Robinson to lead, to counter back, and then he's trying to look for more than Hamed.
Thank you. slip. It's still raining here.
Very confident, standing square on there. Defence right down.
He's talking to Robinson as well. Robinson says, OK, then. He's trying to goad him into coming out of that defensive shell, and he's managed to do that, I think. Now Hamed's trying to open up, and look at Robinson trying to close the range. Now Hamed's laughing.
Taking chances in there to try and get Robinson out of that crab-like defence.
Extraordinary arrogance and bravado from Hamed. I know this big Welsh crowd would love to have those smiles light up his face. He's trying to catch Robinson with one hand. He just hit the snag off him when that's on Hamed. First sign of Robinson being made to struggle by Hamed's power back.
Looking to bring the punches up the middle and right round the sides, trying to find an opening in the hand, held guard of Robinson.
What we have here as well, Ben, of course, is psychological warfare too, with Hamed standing in front of his man, talking to him, waving him in, doing little hip swivels. Robinson is somehow, through all of this, just got to keep his cool and keep his game plan.
That's right, that's very important for Robinson. Scoring in that round, and then content to try and open Robinson up, try to bring the guard down. Not a great deal happening. He just landed with a few better shots, and then inside, just a few up the middle. Robinson still hasn't been able to get to Hamed.
Stone here. There's that very good right uppercut. That just did rock Robinson for a moment or two.
Yes, you see, right in the middle, he really got a lot of power to that. He dipped right down underneath the guard of Robinson, then right up the middle.
Hamed, who in the build-up to this fight described Robinson as a fourth division fighter, and he could beat without training for it, he said. All part of the showmanship that comes with Naseem Hamed. Round three, Studio 12, of course. And giving the second round to Naseem after even opening. Robinson gets through with the right hand. Hamed just smiles, but he was caught significantly by it.
Yes, that was a better punch from Robinson. He's got to try and do that. He's got to, yeah, he's got to keep his guard up. He's got to be tender and making mistakes by Hamed.
Dispiriting at the moment for Robinson, because all he's doing is hitting the night air. He must have thrown about 30 punches in this round, and none of them have landed. Oh, and Hamed catches him with a very hurtful looking right, too. Hamed's the boss at the moment, but it's early.
Yes, Hamed showing good boxing skills, nice and relaxed. And he's just bamboozling Robinson at this moment. Robinson has just got to keep this game plan, just try and apply steady pressure to Hamed. At this moment, he's not been able to get close enough to him.
Throws punches from angles other people wouldn't dream about. Now, he threw a right up the punch, must have started something on his right angle. chances. He really is up for this one, or he should be, because this is a fight which could elevate him to a new level if he can get through it. Brilliant boxing, and that one carries on after the bonus. No love lost in there. I think Robinson's a little bit angry at the moment.
And please ask everybody to be seated.
Naseem Hamed in that round, the last round. Well, you couldn't have hit him with a bag of rice, could you?
No, he moved very well. Look, he's just leaning back, and then he's come out with good counters. Very elusive work there. But this is when Hamed said he was going to finish the fight inside four rounds.
Let's see if he's going to do an Ali and fulfil his prediction. I'm sure he'll remember that. Robinson, let me remind you again, has never been stopped yet in his career of 31 contests. A very good shot at his hand speed as well from Naseem Hamed. Robinson so far has just not been able to apply any pressure because he just can't really land a punch. Not one to speak of anyway.
Well, the problem with Robinson is he comes out of that crouch, he's getting caught with punches.
And then switching from orthodox to southpaw, changing the angle. Trying to befuddle and bemuse Robinson.
Chasing after Hamed so much. I feel he wants Hamed to come to him because Hamed is drawing him into mistakes.
Heads nearly clashed there. And every time Robinson does come out from behind that kind of peekaboo stance of his, Hamed is looking for fast counters. And he's got the speed to do it as well. This point in it is that maybe there'll be other chapters in the story later on for him. He did say he kind of knew it might be like this early on.
Yes, he said he thought he maybe made to look stupid in a few rounds, maybe falling around a little bit. He sensed it would take a few rounds to try to get the habit.
He's doing his own version of the Ali shuffle. Robinson just can't close the range on him. Can't get there with those body shots that would slow Hamed down.
If that's a problem, Robinson needs to get to Hamed to wear him down. And this moment, Hamed isn't allowing him to get in range. You see, good defensive work there from Hamed.
Robinson all the time. Gloves up around his face. Naseem does not win as he predicted in the fourth round. The fighters are looking after four rounds, a third of the battle. Fifth round. Now Naseem starts off by saying to Robinson, come on, try hitting me to the body then. Been talking all the time in there for the champion. Yes, look at the difference in punch type totals. Hamed's landed 89. We reckon to Robinson's 31 so far. I'm struggling to think of the 31 that Robinson's landed. He's missed with many more.
Tremendous reflexes. he's going to need to have them when he carries a defence as low as that. But so far, his reflexes managed to keep him out of the way of Robinson. And when Robinson tries to punch, Hamed comes back with quick counters, and then he's gone.
Somehow, some way, Robinson needs to get in close and to try and bustle him up. Use what might be his superior strength.
Falling around the ring rather than moving around.
mistaken. There is Naseem Hamed's dad, Sol, around the corner, dropping the check on there. All his friends
and be nice thing you do. Be nice to get
Welsh.
You read Hamed's title.
Round and seven. The fans have been absolutely silenced by what they're watching here. Seventh round. Naseem Hamed is a mile ahead. He must be a mile ahead. He'd like to score the fifth round, 10-8, 2-point margin with a knockdown. Absolutely no sympathy so far. Robinson being able to exert any kind of pressure or find a way back into the contest. So far, Robinson hasn't won a round, I don't think, anyway. Agree, Glenn?
Yes, I thought that the first round was probably an even round. After that, it's been Hamed all the way.
So far, the young star from Sheffield is skating away with it on this rainy night in Cardiff. Goes result, really, to Robinson. This is a proud warrior who's having a pretty demoralising, even embarrassing experience in there at the moment. But I think Hamed would do this to a lot of pretty good fighters, don't you?
I'm sure he would. Robinson's a very good fighter, beat a lot of good men. You know, good in lots of ways, very strong. But he's just having... he can't do anything with Hamed. He tries to put in another two, he gets caught, he tries to rush at Hamed, and he walks on the punches.
Surely it can only be a matter of time before Naseem Hamed is unleashed on the American public. There are already stirrings of interest in him over there. Just slowed up a little bit in the last couple of rounds, maybe. That's just a slip. He slipped. The referee stopped it. He stopped the fight as he slipped in the corner, and Prince Naseem Hamed is now king. The coronation of the young star. Prince Naseem Hamed wins his first world championship. He hopes Steve Robinson, and that was really a brilliant display.
You were strong, man.
You
tried fucking really hard.
Steve, you deserve everybody's recognition. Yes.
That's some nice words there, that was nice to see. But poor Steve Robinson. It was a fight, really, that, to be fair to the camp, they didn't want this soon, and they didn't. Well, they felt they weren't getting enough money for it either. That's a round that's still going on. In his first fight at featherweight, you have to say that Naseem Hamed has absolutely proved that he was a worthy number one contender, however controversial it might have been to put him straight in.
That's right. And he's just walking forward like Robinson, just a fast little left hook. You see the legs go all a bit. It's not a slip. He just loses his legs completely. A very quick left hook. He was just posing around, wasn't doing a lot. Took Robinson to the corner, very fast left hook, and his legs just give way completely.
Yeah, there is a wet patch as well in that corner. We saw that in one of the earlier fights. I wondered if he'd lost his footing a bit too.
Yes, it looked a bit like that, but his legs went so violently away from him, didn't they?
Yeah. It was a sort of delayed action for. And there we are. Now that's good to see, because it might just cool the tempers of any hotheads who may want to react to this, but Hamed's victory was so utterly complete that there could be no argument at all about that. That was a stupendous display from him. Again, we still don't know what he's like, but that's because he's so very, very fast and elusive and good that nobody can put him under pressure.
Anyway. He's so very, very quick. Robinson was trying very hard to nail him down, to get to him, but Hamed was just out of the way. He just ducks and slips, and then he turns out of the way, and then he comes back and punches to hurt somebody. A very, very difficult opponent for the B2B.
Well, he wants to, I know, go back down to super bantamweight and win a world championship at that weight. And one of the champions is Marco Antonio Barrera, who's called the baby-faced assassin. And that would be an absolutely brilliant fight if they could ever get that together between those two, because he too apparently is some talent. But for the moment, let's not take it away from Prince Naseem Hamed. He's as good as all the boasts. He's a world champion, and he deserves it.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 1 minute, 40 seconds of the eighth round, the referee has called a halt to the action in favour of the new WBO featherweight champion of the world, Prince Naseem Hamed.
Naz, I have to say, I've never seen anything quite like that in my life.
Now, as you know, I'm not making a big song and dance about it again. You've seen it for yourself now, world champion, the belt's there. The viewers know he's the best. Now, he said he was too strong. Everything his trainers and his manager says, what happened? I was too strong, too fast, and too good, and I'm world champ.
But give him some credit. I mean, a lot of guys would have wilted way before then.
I'll give him so much credit because he was so strong, I was hitting him with everything. I predicted round four. I mean, end of the day, he was very strong. I couldn't do it in round four. Full credit to Stevie, he was very strong. He took best shots of mine. But you know, as world champion, don't you, Gary?
You said you would, and you are. Now, there was a lot of animosity between you two leading up to this. What did you say afterwards? It looked quite sensitive, it looked quite caring.
Yeah, I said to him, you was a great champion. You were so strong, Steve. I've never punched anybody so hard and they've not gone down before that. I was just amazed with his chin, basically. He was a really good fighter. Full credit to Steve. He's been a great champion. And I'm not surprised the way he beat Duke McKenzie and Colin McMillan, Hodgkins and all them, because he's a great fighter. But as you know, tonight's the 30th and I've become King. But I'm not changing my name to King yet. I remain the Prince.
Now tell me about the fight. You were hitting him at will. Did he catch you at all? I mean, just tell me how it went.
Well, you can see my face and you can see his. But he caught me with some good shots. I kept up, caught me with some cracking left hooks, some cracking right hooks. But I'm just too good. I proved it on the night. I proved what I was going to say from the age of 11, 18, when I first started as a professional. I was going to be world champion. I'm world champion today. Frank Warren's my promoter. Brendan Ingle's my manager. They've done the business for me. I've got in and produced the goods every time.
Let's have a word for Brendan, because he's had you for a long time and he's made you what you are. I mean, give him some credit.
No, I'm saying great nothing. Credit. He done the job. Marvellous. And Frank Warren, fair play to him in Sky. I'm over the moon for him. He done the job, and fair play to Steve Robinson. Fought like a champion, plenty of heart, and he took some good shots on the chin and he come back. Over the moon.
Do you think you can fight any better than that? I mean, that is an extraordinary display.
Obviously, I'll get better. As you know, my punching power now, you know it's still extraordinary. And Steve took some great shots. You see what put him down at the end? It was one clean shot. That's what I said. If I catch a man clean, I will take it.
It was a boxing display of utter brilliance. Naseem's verbal goading of Robinson and devastatingly quick combinations broke the champion down bit by bit. The Prince had become King.